Excellent job, Disney. Star Wars is back, ladies and gentlemen. I am happy to report that I had such a great time watching The Mandalorian Season 2. Okay? This is the first time I've been proud of Disney taking over this franchise ever. I'm really happy for Jon Favreau. I'm so glad Kathleen Kennedy didn't produce this, wasn't involved. Keep her out. Okay? Not gonna get into that today. Someday, I have to address this. But for now, this is a happy, happy moment. Ladies and gentlemen, we got Star Wars back, man. And I gotta tell you, man, Season 2 was a banger. Okay? If you got a friend at work, or if you got a friend at school who hasn't seen it, who's maybe, I don't know, tell them, look, sign up for Game Pass right now, and you will get a free month of Disney Plus. Go watch those 8 episodes, cancel that subscription. That's it. That's it! You can also get a free month of Game Pass, too. All these offers are throwing out left and right now. There is no reason why you should not jump into this series, ladies and gentlemen. This is top-tier Star Wars content. High quality. Better than the prequels, some would say. The acting is just great. The storytelling, great. The action, great. Set pieces, great. Concept, great. Just a great, great, great season. Night and day compared to Season 2. Season 1 was meh. But Season 2, 10 out of 10, ladies and gentlemen. Listen, man. You know, I was thinking about making this video, you know, and I was just telling myself, okay, well, let's try, because I'm new to the whole YouTubing community, okay, on how to do this. And I was telling myself, you know what, maybe let's just try to pick out a few episodes that you liked and just talk about them. And I couldn't just pick a few. I liked every episode this season. Every episode was top tier, S tier, 10 out of 10. Great, great, great season. This is what we've all been asking for. This is what we've been wanting to see. Ladies and gentlemen, we're just going to just jump right on in, okay? No more games. Let me just tell you what I liked about Season 2, okay? I'm going to just mention some highlights of all the episodes. That's how I'm going to do this video, okay? But let's start with Episode 1, The Marshal, directed by Jon Favreau. I love this episode because I love Westerns. My mother, she loved Westerns. I love the theme. I'm just a sucker for Westerns, man. I really am. And seeing that character that we got introduced to, Cobb Vanth, being played by Timothy Oliphant, I'm a huge fan of Timothy Oliphant. That's just fat. great, great, great episode, ladies and gentlemen. A great way to start Season 2, man. And then we've got Episode 2, The Passenger, directed by Peyton Reed. And this is the one with the frog lady and her eggs trying to get to the planet so she can have her babies and all of that. This episode was probably on the, considered on the lower tier. But what redeems this episode is the encounter that they have with the X-Wing pilots. They're kind of like the police of space now, so to speak. That was just such an intimidating moment when they just pulled up on each side of Mando like that. And you hear one guy say, hey, switch to channel 2. And it's just dead silent. And all of a sudden you see those wings just opening up. Awesome scene. They made the X-Wing, the X-Wing pilots and the Rebellion. They made them cool, man. And it was great to see them come back at the end and save Mandalorian and the Frog Lady and Grogu. Episode 3, The Heiress. This one was directed by Bryce Dallas Howard. She is so beautiful. I've had a crush on her for a long time. This is the episode that involved Bo-Katan being played by Katie Sackhoff, Starbuck. Any Battlestar Galactica fans out there? I'm also a big fan of Sasha Banks too. I watch WWE as well. This show just has everything in it that I watch outside of it right now, is what I'm telling me. You know, is what it's telling me. Episode one, we got Westerns. I love Westerns. Episode two, the X-Wings are cool. Yeah, but episode three, I love Katie Sackhoff. I'm actually subscribed to her on YouTube and Twitter, and I follow Sasha Banks on Twitter as well too. And it was really great to see Sasha, you know, stepping out of the WWE role, getting out there. You know, I want her to be successful, and I love Katie Sackhoff. I love seeing her back in action doing good acting as well too. I think she looked great, by the way. That was season three, The Heiress. That was episode three, The Heiress. Episode four, The Siege. This one was actually directed by Carl Weathers, the guy who plays Greef Karga, aka Apollo Creed. Great episode, man. This was probably the most high octane, explosive, fast paced episode I had seen this entire season, man. This episode almost felt like a Fast and Furious movie. It really did. Great episode, man. And it had some good comedy too, with that side character that was kind of like a prisoner or whatever. And of course they had a volcano, which was also pretty cool too. Episode five, The Jedi, directed by Dave Filoni. We've seen him direct episodes before in season one, but this one was directed by Dave Filoni, and this is the episode that involves Ahsoka. This was a great episode. I liked Ahsoka. I really like her saber a lot. But this, what really stood out to me in this episode, apart from there being a Jedi, which just amazing. It's always a pleasure to see a Jedi. Okay. But what really fascinated me about this episode was how strong the Beskar steel was. I didn't know that it could just stop a lightsaber like that. I've seen it, you know, block blaster bolts and stuff like that. I've never seen him fight a Jedi before. I didn't know that it was that strong. Maybe you did. I didn't know that. But that was really cool, actually. They had built up this hype about Beskar, about how valuable it is and how strong it is and everything. And, you know, they've always talked, but didn't show. You know, they tell us, but they didn't show us much. This episode, they showed us and didn't have to tell us much. I was very impressed with that. They did a great job with that episode. Episode six, The Tragedy, directed by Robert Rodriguez. This was an amazing episode because I love Boba Fett. It drove me nuts to see him back in that armor too, man. He looks good. He looks good, man. Of course, we got to see Fennec Shand as well too. She's very beautiful. Very beautiful actor. Great episode, man. It was good to see Mandalorian fighting alongside Boba. And it was also really cool to see the Stormtroopers be somewhat of a formidable threat. I mean, they lost. They always lose, but it was cool to see them show up in units and use things like a heavy machine gun and a little bit more of their tech. That episode was really good. And then fighting on the side of that mountain too. That was a good episode. There was some sniping going on in there. It was fun. It was a fun episode. Episode seven, The Believer, directed by Rick Famuyiwa. I might have butchered that one. This one involves Mayfield, the returning character from season one, played by Bill Burr. I really like Bill Burr. I've been liking Bill Burr for about a year and a half now. I've been YouTubing a lot of his stand-up comedy clips, and I think the guy is funny. And I've never really gotten into his whole movies and TV shows, never really caught on to him there, but his comedy is great. But I really like the dialogue between him and Mandalorian when they're talking about helmets and stuff like that. Great episode, man. That guy just brings a whole different kind of energy to the cast, to be honest. And of course, the scene that that really stands out to a lot of people is when Well, Mayfield runs into his old commanding officer, a character named Valen Hess, who's played by Richard Brake. We've seen him, I've seen him in a few other movies before. He's always played this kind of sleazy kind of guy. I remember if you've ever seen the original Doom movie starring The Rock, he was in that movie. So, a great episode. Of course, we got to see the Mandalorian's face for the first time, which I did not expect to see. That totally caught me. It happened so fast. And, you know, when we were watching that episode, you know, and they were talking about helmets and everything, Gabby, she actually kind of pegged it on a little bit earlier on. She's like, I think we're going to see his face. And I was like, no, they're not going to do that. They'll probably wait till another season or before he dies or something like that, you know. And then 20 minutes later, we see his face and mustache. Great episode, man. And that whole dialogue with Valen Hess and Mayfield and Mando in the mess hall was just great. I was telling Gabby, that reminded me of the scene from Inglourious Basterds when they were in the basement playing the little beer game. You know, I'm a big Inglourious Basterds fan. That's one of my favorite movies. That was a very intimidating scene as well, too. If you haven't seen that movie, I highly suggest you all check that out. But that was a wonderful episode. Now, let's get to the season finale of season 2, episode 8. This episode was so special. I did not expect them to have a really good season finale. I was under the impression, I was telling myself, man, this has been a really good season. I don't see how they could top it. And they did. And they didn't top it in, you know, ways of action or I mean, there was action. There was a little bit of suspense in there. But they did it in a way that I just did not expect. Kudos to them once again, man. So let's get right into it. Episode 8, The Rescue, directed by Peyton Reed. And this is an episode where a bunch of them, almost all the gangs all together again, except for Bill Burr and Timothy Oliphant and Ahsoka and Carl Weathers as well, too. A great episode. It was really good seeing, you know, Mandalorian fighting with Boba Fett and Bo-Katan and Sasha Banks. And it was just a great episode, man. I really enjoyed them making their plans to get on, what's that guy's name? The bad guy's ship. Gideon's ship right now. And speaking of Gideon, he does not have the physical prowess I wanted him to have. He's a very intelligent man. I think that's what makes him so special is how intelligent and cool he is. The fight between him and Mandalorian was a little bit lackluster. But that's okay. I almost feel like he needs to have a Sith with him. Okay? That darksaber is awesome. That's the coolest saber I've ever seen next to the purple one. Okay? I love it. Great episode. But listen, all of that was great in the episode, okay? But when we see in the background an X-Wing just kind of coasting by the windows there, everybody's just like looking like, I'm getting too thirsty talking about this, all right? I saw that X-Wing pull up, and I thought this in my brain. I did not say it with my mouth. I thought to myself, man, that would be crazy if it was Luke, because he always flew around in an X-Wing, even in that crappy Rise of the Skywalker movie. He shows up. We don't see his face yet. But if you noticed, I went back and I watched this again. His entrance is the same as Vader's entrance on Rogue One. Do you guys remember near the end of Rogue One? When Vader finally shows up and all the rebels are in that tight little dark hallway shooting at him and he's just casually walking up to them and he's just deflecting all the blaster bolts. He's doing some force stuff and all that. Luke does the same thing. I told myself, is that really Luke? Because A, the green lightsaber, I was like, hey, that's a green lightsaber. and B, the black glove from his hand being cut off. And I was just like, oh my God, they're not really doing this, are they? But then when he was doing the same thing that his dad did in Rogue One, I had chills going down my spine, ladies and gentlemen. The way that camera just slowly kind of pans back as he's moving forward and just dealing with those Dark Trooper droids, that was another thing that felt kind of lackluster to me. The Dark Trooper droids were meh, okay? Gideon, I'm ready for you to be out the picture, my friend, okay? Bring on the blue guy. But anyway, awesome, awesome entrance, you know? And I was just losing my mind. And that moment, he took that cloak off of his head. I don't know if that was CG or if that was an actor that looked like him or if it was the CG makeup or all the above. I don't know. But when he took that cloak off, I lost it. I had chills going down my spine, ladies and gentlemen. This was the Luke that we've all been wanting to see. This was the Luke that when we were all kids, that we had action figures, we wanted to be like, okay? Not this shit that Kathleen Kennedy decided to come up with for the new sequel where he's this loser who doesn't want to be a Jedi, who's this curmudgeon old... No. We wanted to see a Luke that had an appreciation for the Force. That's what we wanted to see. And we wanted to see him do some cool shit. And that's what we got, ladies and gentlemen. And I guess it was just so hype for me after being so let down from what Luke did in Rise of Skywalker and whatever those other trilogies were. This takes the cake, ladies and gentlemen. This season two is the Star Wars that we all love, the true fans all love. And this is a Star Wars that everybody can get into, okay? Not this new stuff where it has such terrible, you got terrible acting, terrible characters, terrible plots, weak villains, except Kylo Ren. I love me some Kylo Ren. But I'm talking about the other guy, that freaking nasty clone, whatever his name was. But this was the Star Wars that we all enjoyed and loved. Every episode of this season had something that I loved. Started from episode one, the Western vibe. I love that. Episode two, X-Wings. I love that. Episode three, The Heiress, directed by Bryce Dallas Howard. I love that woman. And I love Katie Sackhoff. And I love Sasha Banks. Episode four, Carl Weathers, high octane. Fast and Furious, like. Episode five, The Jedi, man. We got to freaking see Ahsoka. And let me tell you about that, by the way. There is something that has to tell you something, that when I saw episode five, I told myself, man, maybe I need to go back and really watch the Clone Wars, because I've seen like a couple of episodes of it and I kind of get the gist. I was like, man, that tells you that it makes you want to go back and look into something that you may have just skimmed over, really didn't care much for. I remember I was out smoking a cigarette and Gabby even asked me about it. And I was like, man, for them to just tease a little bit of the past, to have somebody who is not familiar with the character want to know a little more about the character, that's how you know they have good content this season. Of course, we've got episode six, The Tragedy, Boba Fett coming back into the scene. Episode seven, okay, Mayfield, my man, Bill Burr, of course. Episode eight as well, Luke coming back. And something else about that, right, moments before that, I did notice that they started to play his theme song right up to the crescendo and then they just cut it off. It didn't come to my mind until afterwards, actually, after all it was said and done and everything, and I was just replaying the events in my head. But ladies and gentlemen, I'm so glad Kathleen Kennedy was not involved in this. I want her to stay away from The Mandalorian. I don't want her involved in any other Star Wars shows that they got planned. I don't want her involved in the Book of Boba Fett. I don't want her involved in the Obi-Wan series. I don't want her near Star Wars at all, okay? Jon Favreau, ladies and gentlemen, if you are not familiar, this man is mostly responsible for the MCU that we have today. This was a terrific season, and I highly suggest everyone get on board. Check it out. There are too many reasons why you should just go watch it, man. Go watch it. All right? 10 out of 10. Wonderful content. In the meantime, I want to wish everybody well. I want to thank you all for stopping by and checking out my video. I know it's been a rough year for us all, but let's all just hang in there a little bit longer, be there for each other, support each other, and be safe. And may the force be with you. Good night.